How you doing? I thought the part one was comical at times and really crap at other times, you know, and these things happen. But thankfully, we're getting towards the stage part of the album that I really enjoy. Sorry about the glass, I look like a freak, but they are what they are. They're not mine. Just spent 7 minutes trying to get this thing tuned up. What this song is about, it always sort of reminds me of
limb by limb, tooth by tooth, stirring up inside of me. Wish that I was bulletproof.
So turning it now. I always love the selling point, you know.
So pay me money, take a shot, fill the lead, fill holes in me. Oh, I could burst a million bubbles on surrogate.
I now know that it's just slightly out of tune. It's a great little... what it's about. I mean, Tom York, Eddie O'Brien, the Groove Tunes, and Philip Selway. It's a nice tune. I've always liked it. It's a great way to tune your guitar to know what it is. Red Dove. So I tried a really bland version of this in Irish before. Didn't really work out. Always reminds me of I suppose when I had a girlfriend for a long time. We lived together for a few years, more than a few years, a long time. And I suppose towards the end of that relationship, you sort of go from being going out with this luscious woman who you really find attractive to kind of like, it's almost like your sister or something. It's weird, you know. And I always sort of reminded me, you kind of blame the other person, but it's probably you as well. You know what I mean? You're just like, feeling's gone, you know? But, I think the string is dying. Thank you. how the Mitch are gone, you know, it's kind of like that fucking creepiness or the weirdness of seeing someone who you think is them, you know. I stand at the station, I just look around, now that I don't think of you. What you do, like, you know, that's sort of, it's an irony in there, or sarcasm, you know. But I go a week, I fall down, I pass out. When I see a face like you, what do I gonna do? Yes, I'm built from inside. Oh, blame it on the black star. Blame it on the falling sky. Blame it on the sun. Nice song. My guitar is still not fucking tuned, but I think it's a dead string. I'm gonna have to get new strings, I think. I've got new strings. Maybe I'm just a bit too alert. It's a nice song though. Silk, great song. Right. You're back through the wall. Walls bites back. Sit there and soak. You sit there and moan. You are so pretty. Each time it comes, eats me alive. Try to behave, but it's eats me alive. So I declare a holiday. Drifting away. it's a good one. It kind of, I think it's kind of a B-side to the other one. And then we're left with this, like, monster. Actually, I know the chords to this, and I know how to play it. The only awkward thing about playing this is, obviously, the range, which demonstrates York's cool range again. And it's the words, obviously. It's kind of dystopic. It's kind of, I don't know what Britain's problem is. It's a fucking great country. They're really clever. They're really funny. They're smart people. They're just kind of, I think it's maybe the working class, they feel a bit guilty or something. I don't know what it is, but. I mean, how would I interpret this? Rows of houses all bearing down on me. I can feel their hand, blue hands touching me. All these things in their position. You know, I wouldn't be complaining about having a house and somewhere to live in a community to develop. Like, you know, I think as a result of I suppose, you know, the Conservatives, whatever they did there in the 80s, yeah, they shut it all down. But, like, go with it. Like, you know, I mean, you're smart people. You like, what about it? Like, you'll be fine. London's a fucking toilet. It's an overrated toilet. But, I mean, the rest of the country is cool. Honestly, like, you've got a great country there. What are you giving out about? Like, and fuck the begrudges. Like, I mean, you know, like, I always laughed at all your humour anyway. I thought you're gas fuckers. I mean, only if you're Top of the Pops, I'd be ruined. You know, nothing wrong with you. So get over it, like. Unless you're from Gloucester and you're a cunt, then you really need to have a good look at yourself. Sorry, all you boys in Gloucester. Thank you. that was it. I suppose it still took me 22 minutes and I didn't even spoof. It's a great album. Benz, great album, enjoy it. I see you later. We're coming straight back with this one there, which is arguably better. I don't know. I'd love to know when they were published. The book 2001, it's actually 2 for $33. So I got the two of them. I bought them simultaneously. I bought them the same time. Definitely did, and for £20, it was a bargain, wasn't it? Jeepers, when you think of the 20 quids you'd fucking throw on shite. I'd love to know when it was actually ready. They're a five-headed phenomenon that comes alive when making music. They previously released 5 EPs, exceptional music, no more deemed suitable for daytime radio except Creep. And this is the sort of spiel here. And this was it. Like, I mean, in fairness, the Benz is, it's arguably their, it's their album after their breakthrough, you know. I mean, there was so much good independent music in the UK at the time. You have to remember, I think this is like the Benz, 1994, perfect. I mean, that makes about sense. I mean, there was loads of people doing pills. They were all having the right laugh. There was an alternative thing happening with the acid house scene. It was just coming out of that. These guys were proper, like, you know. I mean, there was, they knew what they were at, and they were decent. So, like, I mean, and they had a cool singer. Like, it's that simple. Like, John Leckie, he produced it. It's good, you know. It's a bit angsty. It's a bit middle classy, whatever you want to call it. It's a great album, you know. It's not like you know, Madhouse up in Manchester. But like, look, it is what it is. Like, you know, I'm gonna record the first bit of OK Computer now later on. So I hope you enjoy it. And sorry about the glass. I look a bit of a streep, but like, I literally can't read without them. I can, but they're just kind of helping. So see you later. I hope you enjoyed that. And I don't know if I should redo the first bit. I was, you know, but I mean, look, it is what it is. There's not like the concept is authenticity, you know, and it has to be done. Farts, crapness, bad voiceness, hoarseness, cringiness, everything has to go in. It's got to be there, and that's what it's got to look like, and that's the way it is. And like, even if I sound or look a bit like fucking, you know, some ponce from fucking, you know, whatever, I don't fucking care, you know. It is what it is. It's you know, and I hope you're getting a buzz out of it, and if you're not, I hope you're not getting a buzz out of it. Like, I hope you're getting a buzz out of it going, what's that like, you know? And I'm sorry about this guitar not being tuned. I actually, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to change the string of that guitar. See you later.